Welcome back. So what I'm going to do here in this video is I'm going to go over exercise 6 from decision analysis. I'm going to try to set up using precision tree so you can see how we can set up this multi-stage decision problems using decision tree. And let's start. Okay, so the questions are given here. Feel free to pause the video and go through it. So this company faces several decisions. For example, whether to drill or no drill in order to find oil, and whether to conduct a survey or not, because if they do conduct a survey and the report of this survey came out to be favorable, then there is a higher likelihood the field may contain oil. Without a survey, they realize there's about a 45% chance that the field will contain oil. But with a favorable survey, this chance of having oil is going to be 80%. With an unfavorable report, the chance of the field contains oil is going to be only 10%. So we want to start building this decision tree. And I've already loaded my Excel and precision tree as well. So let's start with building it. We always start from left to right. And I'm going to click on a cell here. I'm going to start with this one. Okay, we're going to call this tree the company of this question. That's all you call. Okay, and the very first node we have here is actually a decision node. So I'm going to change this to a decision node. Okay, so as far as branches are concerned, if you think carefully, there's actually a 3 branches for this first decision node. Survey or drill, that means no survey. And the third one is no drill, also means no survey. So let's work on that. So 3 branches. The very first one we have is going to be, we have survey. Okay. Does the survey cost us anything? So that's going to be correspond to value. So will we know that drilling itself costs $1 million? If there's oil, that's going to be a profit of $6 million. $100K, that's 0.1 million for survey. So survey itself costs 0.1 million. I'm going to use everything in million. So that's 0.1. That's the cost. So I'm using negative value. So the next one is just going to be drill. So drill costs $1 million. If the company decides no drill, well, no drill, there will be no value, no cost for that. So I'm just going to put OK. So our first node, as you can see here. And the next, what we want to do is I'm going to go with a drill. That means no survey. If they decide they're going to drill, is they're going to face it with a chance node, because there's a certain chance of having found oil and there's a certain likelihood not finding oil. If they decide to drill without a survey, the company believes there's a 45% chance of it contains oil. So 45 chance it has oil, and 55 chance of no oil. If there's an oil, well, you make $6 million. If there's no oil, well, you don't make anything, right? Okay, so it's a chance node here, a chance node. And this chance node, I'm going to call it, did it find oil or not? So it found oil. And that's a 45% chance. Well, that's going to be $6 million, I think. Yes, $6 million, as you can see here. Right. Okay. If they didn't find oil, so no oil. And that's going to be 55% chance. Make sure they add up to 100% and there's 0. So click OK. The next is for no drill. If it's no drill, you just end there. So as you can see, represented by the triangle node, that's a terminal node. Now I'm going to move on to the survey. For the survey, after you decide you're going to make a survey, what you're going to face it with is going to be the outcome of the survey. Well, there's going to be a favorable report versus an unfavorable report. For a favorable report, there's a 50% chance. And another 50% chance of an unfavorable report. So it's a chance node. Click on here, a chance node. So this chance node, we can call it report or outcome. So if it's a favorable it's going to be 50. And the value, you don't actually lose anything or gain anything for that, because you have already paid for the report in the early stage. You had paid $0.1 million for that. So favorable, unfavorable, click OK. Great. Okay, so just say it is a favorable report. You're going to decide whether you're going to drill or no drill, right? Well, that looks like what we have here. First is we're going to, is a decision note. It's going to be drill versus no drill. If it's a drill, there's a cost for that. If it's no drill, there isn't any cost. Right. Okay, we have already have the drill part ready, and after the drill is going to be either found oil is a chance note, or maybe no oil found. What I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this subtree, this tree here to here, right? I'm just going to right click here, copy subtree, and I go to this node. I right click. And you can paste it here. Okay, one thing that you do have to remember is you have to come here to check the net values to make sure they are what you wanted. Okay, so for favorable report, the probability of finding oil is actually 80%. So you want to change this to 80. You're going to change the next one to 20. Remember, those two add up to 100. Right, so this is what we got. Okay. For no drill, well, you're just going to end it there. Same goes for unfavorable report. First is you want to change this to a decision note. Drill. No drill. You can certainly copy the previous subtree as well. I'm just going to do it here. Wait a second. If you decide to drill, there's a cost to it, $1 million, right? You can click OK. Yes, and now I'm going to paste this subtree again. So I'm going to copy it here. Copy subtree and paste it here again. Right click. And we would have to change the likelihoods as well. Okay, if it's an unfavorable report, the likelihood of finding oil is only 10%. So I'm going to change this to 10%. And no oil is going to be certainly be 90%. Right? Okay, so this is what we get. Let's take a look to see whether we are able to get everything right. I think that's pretty much how you set up the tree. Okay, what's the final outcome here? What's the optimal tree here? You can read the optimal tree using true or false here. So the first is a decision node. Out of those three branches, you can see they are false, false. So you take this branch. So that means the company should carry out a survey. If it's a favorable report, you drill, right? And that's going to give you expected monetary value of 3.7. If it's an unfavorable report, you shouldn't drill. You shouldn't drill. And that's going to give you expected monetary value of a negative 0.1, right? And so you can figure out here, the expected monetary value is 1.8 as well. So that's going to be a report outcome, the expected monetary value of the entire decision tree. This can also be seen by going into decision analysis. Policy suggestion, you click OK, and precision tree is able to tell us what is the optimal tree, as you can see. So this is the optimal tree, same as the one we got earlier, we talked about. It's just a truncated version of it. Okay, I'm just going to stop the video here because the rest of the calculation is very standard to the example we shown in the video. Great. Thank you very much for watching, and hope you find this video helpful.